Good evening. I'm Lenka DeVor, and welcome to Nottingham News. Today's main headlines. The fully stocked larder that's been revealed lurking behind the debris and poverty of the Maltbury disaster. We take a tour around your school pitches to see what you've got lined up for Champions Week. And we'll be bringing you the latest on who's new in the pits this week. But first, our main story tonight. As if the temporary loss of their homes weren't enough, residents of Maltby Village, devastated in last week's cliff collapse, have discovered that one of their own has been keeping a private food store. As volunteers from the High Caste Salvation Programme distributed breakfast rations to the displaced residents, in a cruel case of irony, they were only metres away from the den of luxury where farmer Brian Hamble had stashed several pounds of produce. According to guardsmen who confiscated the hoard, there was easily enough to feed a fifth of the outer circle for a month. Mr. Hamble was promptly apprehended. Amidst reports of riotous feasting, concerned citizens wonder how many more farmer Hambles are out there, and how many of their much-needed supplies are being kept from them. With a date for Hamble's trial yet to be set, it may be several weeks before answers are forthcoming. As we look forward to this year's championship, schools and universities all over East Mercia are putting in the hours to get their pitches, tracks and teams ready for Champions Week. And may I say how wonderful it is to see so many of you taking to social media to spread the word about what your school or college is doing this year. Special mentions go to the staff and pupils of the Alderbridge Institute, who began assembling their own Fleetfoot course on the sports field this week. And to Ella and Matt Davenport from Tuckenham Grammar, who are being sponsored to carry out their own swordathon in their garden, all with their parents' supervision, of course. They've already raised 816 okies for sustainability initiatives around East Mercia. Nice job, you two, and keep us posted. And Barton University wished to remind students that there are still slots available at the rifle range if you're gunning for a go. With all these exciting events ramping up, I'd say our professional champions had better watch their backs. A new generation is emerging. New in the pits this week is Jeremy Ardwick, the Hellhound of Huntingdon, whose killing spree we remember all too keenly after 8 were slain and another 5 left fighting for their lives in Loxton. Now it's his life on the line. But he'll have good company in Estelle Yarrow, the guard garrotting granny from Greenwood, whose despicable crimes speak for themselves, and who has evaded capture for a frightening number of years. I wouldn't want to be faced with those two. So our sympathies go out to poor Ollie Porter, whose claim to be related to the Aldridge family was quickly denounced by a simple DNA test. Not pit material, you might think, but think again. Young Ollie was living it up in the inner circle, taking advantage of your hard work, taking things he was not entitled to. He was taking it easy at that point, but he won't be taking it quite so easy from now on. Weather watch now. And the alert rating has risen from green to yellow following a summery week which saw temperatures rise by as many as 8 degrees across East Mercia. The advice we have from the Nottingham Meteorological Office is to stay alert, but not to panic. For most of us, this week will close out on a sunlit note. In other news, the Council of East Mercia are strongly advising citizens to think before they travel outside the bounds of Nottingham and other duchy capitals, and to travel for essential reasons only. As we reported last week, bandit attacks are on the rise, and the Council is reportedly considering the creation of a dedicated task force to police interurban areas after a petition received 800 signatures. Inner Circle gardeners are once more preparing themselves for the annual Open Garden Day on Friday. This year's theme is A Garden for Tomorrow and aims to shine a light on how gardeners can branch out into sustainable uses of their space. After our item a couple of weeks back, I'll wager we'll be seeing a few bee hotels around. And finally, it's a third week at number one for Lost Chops with I'm Getting a Funny Feeling from You. The band have declared through their manager, Freya Dean, that if the song stays at the top for 8 weeks, they'll donate all the profits to a food bank. Now, I don't think I'm alone in saying what a magnanimous gesture that would be. So, make sure you get out there and buy their song. I can't help myself, it's just so catchy. And that's all we have time for on Nottingham News today. Thank you for joining us, and for more stories, once again, take a look at our website. The link is on the screen now. Until next week, stay safe. Help whoever and wherever you can, and goodbye. May Hecate bless you.